Buddhist Science is a study on Buddhism based on facts and science.
The Notions of Self and No Self in Buddhism Part 2, by Venerable Rungruang Papatsaro, Dr. Rungruang Limchoopatipa. In Buddhism, the rations for the mind is no self, can be exemplified as in following rations. No self-explanation by insight observation on arising and cessation of the object of consciousness in related to the five aggregates of being. By seeing so, clearly a life is a natural process which is no self. And there is no self who governs and controls a life as five aggregates of being. No self-explanation by proof in induction on the object of consciousness that because it is impermanent and deteriorating, therefore it is no self as it is uncontrollable. The ration behind this induction is that, since everything is impermanent and deteriorating, but most people may want them to be permanent, and not deteriorating. There is no one who can control to be as wish, therefore there is no self. And there is no self who governs and controls a life as five aggregates of being. No self-explanation by proof by contradiction, that is, assuming that if it is self, then there is someone who can control the object of consciousness in related to body, feeling perception, mental formations, and consciousness. However, this is not a case because these five aggregates of being are arising and cease by certain cause and effect in nature. Therefore, by contradiction, a life is no self. And there is no self who governs and controls a life as five aggregates of being. No self-explanation by the concept of element in nature, that is, by considering that it is a natural property such as solid property, as compared to soil, liquid property, as compared to water, gas property, as compared to wind, energy property, as compared to fire, that already exists in nature. Therefore, it is no self. In Buddhism, the concept of element also includes the properties of feeling, perception, mental formations, consciousness that already exist in nature, not created by anyone, therefore all the mental phenomena are no self. And there is no self who governs and controls a life as five aggregates of being. No self-explanation by the concept of six sense bases. That is, the mind processing starts by having a consciousness at the six sense bases as a part of natural phenomenon, therefore the mind is no self. And there is no self who governs and controls a life as five aggregates of being. No self-explanation by the concept of the process of dependent origination, that is, the mind is a process of dependent origination happened by a certain cause and effect in nature, therefore the mind is no self as follows.
Each part of dependent origination, namely ignorance, mental formations, consciousness, name and form, six sense bases, contact, feeling, craving, clinging, existence, birth, aging and death is impermanent, conditioned, dependently arisen, subject to destruction, vanishing, fading away, and cessation. A noble disciple has clearly seen with correct wisdom as it really is this dependent origination and these dependently arisen mental phenomena.
No self-explanation by the concept of ownership, that is, the object of consciousness in relation to the five aggregates of being is not owned by anyone, it happens just as a natural process as explained by the Venerable Kīmaka as follows.
Friends, even though a noble disciple has abandoned the five lower fetters, still, in relation to the five aggregates subject to clinging, there lingers in him a residual conceit, I am, a desire, I am, an underlying tendency, I am, that has not yet been uprooted. As he dwells thus contemplating rise and fall in the five aggregates subject to clinging, the residual conceit, I am, the desire, I am, the underlying tendency, I am, that had not yet been uprooted. This comes to be uprooted.
When this was said, the elder monk said to the Venerable Kīmaka,
We did not ask our questions in order to trouble the Venerable Khemaka, but we thought that the Venerable Khemaka would be capable of explaining, teaching, proclaiming, establishing, disclosing, analyzing, and elucidating the Blessed One's teaching in detail. And the Venerable Khemaka has explained, taught, proclaimed, established, disclosed, analyzed, and elucidated the Blessed One's teaching in detail.
Thus, the elder monks were elated and delighted in the Venerable Khemaka's statement. And while this discourse was being spoken, the minds of 60 elder monks and of the Venerable Khemaka were liberated from the taints by non-clinging. The discovery of the truth that a life is no self in Buddhism, is a breakthrough understanding of what is the meaning of life. In Buddhism, life does exist, and everything, including every phenomenon, dharma, in nature also exist, but they are not created or controlled by any self. Everything and all phenomena happening in nature are caused by certain condition under the law of nature, which is no self. However, if we learn the truths of life and knowing the law of nature correctly, then we can maneuver on a certain cause and action to get a certain result rightly. It is wisdom that we have to develop, not a blind belief or faith. The present scientific study, we know that a body is composed of several billions of cells living together in a biology system. Each individual cell a certain genetic blueprint called DNA, with RNA as a protein synthesis used in all parts of body, and mRNA is the way that a cell communicates all the various parts of the body to make sure that a cell sensitizes the right kind of protein within the body. Therefore, there is no such a self in a body at all. The body is just the way all the cells in a body live, by communicating each other and synthesizing a proper protein to sustain the whole biology system. And for the mind in human connectome project, scientists discovers that what so-called a mind indeed consists of mental phenomena of objects of consciousness in related to the five aggregates of being is just a natural process of signal processing within a central nervous system. Therefore, it arrives to the conclusion that both body and mind are no self, and thus a life is no self as well. Understanding the truth that a life is no self is so important in Buddhism that when performing an insight investigation on mental phenomena, and realizing that a life is indeed no self, then the mind will make a significant development in such a way that the mind will be able to liberate the object of consciousness at clinging, and to dispassionate the mind from the world at craving, including having nothing to mix with latent dispositions at ignorance simultaneously, and resulting in arising taint within the mind processing. So-called the process of dependent origination is completely collapsed at craving, clinging, and ignorance, respectively. In conclusion, the reality of life within nature is that, by breaking the components of life into the five aggregates of body, feeling, perception, mental formations, and consciousness, we discover that a life is a natural process of the process of dependent origination, and each component of the dependent origination can be viewed as an element in nature, so there is no one who creates and able to control them. These mental phenomena are arising and fading away within a short instant, so they are impermanent, deteriorating, and no self. A life is what it is in nature. All in all, in the study on mind and study on wisdom in the threefold study strategy in Buddhism is the knowledge that a life is no self. The words nature, no self, and emptiness share a similar implication of life, that it is primarily no self in different contexts. That is, a life is a natural process by the law of nature which is not of anyone control, so it is no self. And by having a good understanding of the world rightly, we can dispassionate the world, and liberating the mind from any object of consciousness. By then, the mind is liberated from the taints by non-clinging as sort of emptiness.